Here is the top 20 PowerPoint 2016 tips and tricks. This is a quick rundown of the top PowerPoint 2016 tips and tricks. Let's get started. Number 1, Morph Transition. Morph is a very cool transition effect between two slides. To enable it, take a slide and duplicate it. Go to the second slide, choose the Morph option, and move items around the screen. Click the Morph one more time, and you'll see the transition between the two. Number 2, Compress Media. You have the ability to add videos inside of a PowerPoint presentation. You just go to Insert, select Video, and choose a file, and it inserts it into your PowerPoint. But what happens if that file is too large for emailing or saving or playing back on Skype or some other location? You can actually compress the file size. Just go to File, and notice this Compress Media option. It'll be there if you have media inside your PowerPoint presentation. And right here it says the media files in this presentation are 66 meg. You can click this to compress it and choose a different type of quality to lower the size. So I'm going to choose internet quality. It's going through a processing of that file. And when it's complete, you can see that it saved 21.1 megabytes. Now under the Info tab, you can see that file is actually 45 megabytes. If you want to change it, you can come back in here, click Undo, and then click it again to choose another quality level. Number 3, Control Drag to duplicate. Want to know the fastest way to duplicate information? Just hold the Control key down, click on an object, and then drag it. Simple as that. Number 4, Ink Equation. Here's a slick trick to creating an equation on your PowerPoint slide. Just go to Insert, Symbols, under Equation, hit the down arrow, and choose Ink Equation. Now write a math equation by hand. And click Insert. Number 5, Alt-Shift Ordering. Let's say you want to reorder the items in a bulleted list. The shortcut to do that is to highlight what you want to move, hold the Shift-Alt keys down, and hit the up arrow or down arrow to move the item around. Number 6, Ungroup SmartArt. SmartArt is a great tool to insert graphics into your PowerPoint presentation, but did you know that you can break all the components of the SmartArt out into separate items? When you insert SmartArt, it adds it to your presentation as one item. But if you right-click on the block, choose Group, Ungroup, and then do it a second time, it actually breaks out each component as a separate item, and you can edit, move, and adjust it however you want. Number 7, Quick Access Toolbar. The Quick Access Toolbar is in the upper left corner of all Office products. And you can see it defaults to 4 or 5 icons here for different commands. If you click the down arrow and go to More Commands, you can choose from this list to add other items to the Access Toolbar. What I like to do is go into Commands Not in Ribbon and select 3 that I use frequently. First one is Quick Print. So click and add that. Second one is Speak. And the third one is Toggle Case. Hit OK, and it now adds those commands. The Quick Print is handy because you can click this button to automatically print directly to your default printer without having to go through the menus. The Speak Selected Text allows you to have the computer read back your text. If you highlight something and click Speak,
the top 20,
it plays it for you. And the third one allows you to toggle the case. So whatever you've highlighted will switch between all uppercase, all lowercase, or caps. You'll find a number of other commands that you may want to add to your Quick Access Toolbar to make that one-click button away. Number 8, Filler Text. Sometimes it's handy to have filler text on your PowerPoint presentation. To add some random filler text, just click the Insert button, pick a text box, locate where you want the text to be positioned, and type directly into the box, equals lorem, and hit Enter. That will fill in Latin text. Then you can resize as necessary and move it around to the positioning that you need. Rather than Latin text, you can do random text. Just type in equals R-A-N-D with parentheses and hit Enter. Both of these commands allow options in the parentheses, the number of paragraphs, and the number of sentences within each paragraph, so you can adjust it accordingly. Number 9, chart animations. By default, when you create a chart in your PowerPoint presentation, it comes up all at once. But you can add animation to make it look better and allow you to communicate while you're bringing up each component of the chart. Click on the chart, choose the Animations tab, and click on the Animation pane to bring up this menu. Now choose an animation for the chart, like Fly In. Make sure this is highlighted, and click Effect Options, and come down here and choose by series or by category. When you choose by series, it brings up each graph series one step at a time. And if you choose by category, it brings up the entire category one group at a time. So when you present your slide, it gives you the opportunity to hit the arrow key, bring up the title and the categories and series information so you can explain what that is about. Then bring up category 1, category 2, 3, and 4. This makes for a better presentation. Number 10, slideshow tricks. When you're in the middle of a presentation, you can actually use a number of shortcut tricks to help communicate your message. You can see the list of options here by hitting the F1 key. The ones to note is you can hit the W key to white out your screen, hit it again to bring it back. You can also hit B to blank the screen out so that you have nothing on the display, and hit Escape to come back. If you hit Control P, it brings up a pointer, and you can use this to mark things on your chart while you're talking. If you hit E, it will erase and start over. Control I brings up a highlighter so you can highlight items on your chart. And again, E to erase. And you can hit the plus and the minus to zoom in and zoom out. If you hit minus all the way out, it actually brings up all of your presentation pages, and you can click on the one that you want to go to. Remember, all of these are available by hitting F1. Number 11, Gridlines and Guides. For a professional-looking PowerPoint presentation, it's important to get alignment correct on objects that you have on your page. A couple of tools that help you do that are the Gridlines and Guides. You can find them under the View tab. If you turn on Guides, it brings up a horizontal and vertical line in the center of the screen. When you hover over that, you can actually move these lines where you want to position alignment. And then you can take your object and you can move it into that position and it'll snap right there. You can also turn on Gridlines and see the background gridlines to help align other things around the page, or move your guide as you need to for those different objects. If you hit the arrow key in the corner here, it gives you some options. You can choose to snap to the grid, and you can also adjust the spacing for the particular grid settings. If you click this set as default, it will store that setting for other pages and other presentations. And finally, you can turn on the ruler, which shows the number of inches vertically and horizontally across your page if you need to do things by measurement. Number 12, recover files. If you've been kicked out of PowerPoint or you forgot to save a file, not to worry, there is one possible chance that you can recover it. Go to File, Open, and at the bottom of the list, you'll see this Recover Unsaved Presentations. Click that. It opens the unsaved file location, and if anything is in there, you may be able to click on it, open it up, and recover that file. Number 13, Eyedropper. The easiest way to match text color with some other object is to highlight the text that you want to change, click on the color option, go down to Eyedropper, and then select the color that you want from any place on the screen. It automatically changes it to that color. Number 14, Shape Edit Points. Shape Edit Points is a powerful tool that allows you to make any kind of combination of shape you can think of. Start by inserting a shape onto your canvas, and then click the Edit Shape Edit Points option. This gives you the ability to take corners of the drawing and shift them around. You can also create new points inside of the drawing. And you can right-click and do a curve segment, which adds a curve to that edge. So it gives you the ability to move and manipulate a shape in a variety of different ways. Now combine this with the morph option we talked about earlier, and you can make some very creative animations. Number 15, Smart Lookup. Smart Lookup is a feature that's available in all the Office applications. All you have to do is take a group of text, highlight a particular word or phrase, and then click on the Review, Smart Lookup. It goes to the web, looks up the topic, and gives you some information. Number 16, Slideshow Loop. You may want to do a PowerPoint presentation as an introduction slideshow, where it continuously loops through your slides without any intervention. Click on Slideshow, Setup Slideshow, and check this box to loop continuously. Make sure that the timings, if present, is also checked and it's not on manual. Hit OK. Now go to your Transitions tab. Turn off the check mark for on mouse click and make sure that it's selected on the timer. I'm going to put in 1 second. And then on your second slide, do the same thing. I'm going to do 2 seconds. Now go into your presentation. And it continuously loops through your presentation. Number 17, Embed Fonts. If you insert a variety of different fonts into your PowerPoint presentation and then take it somewhere and present using somebody else's computer, you may want to embed fonts to make sure you don't have any problems with the font types or the spacing. All you have to do is go to File, Options, click on the Save option, and check this box to embed fonts in the file, and hit OK. This guarantees that you won't have problems trying to present your fonts running it from another machine. Number 18, remove background. PowerPoint 2016 has some nice features for editing photos. For example, if you want to remove the background on this picture, just click on the photo, choose Format, click on Remove Background, and it highlights all of the area that you want to remove. It gives you a sample of what it looks like over in the left area here. And as you can see, the beak is something that's going to be removed. So we can fix that by clicking this mark areas to keep and then highlight that. And when we're done making our changes, click keep changes. And now you have the background removed. Number 19, quick alignment. If you have a number of objects on your page and you want to align them, there's a quick method to do that. Just select all of the objects that you have, go to Format, choose Align, and if you want to align them to the left, or if you want them centered, or to the right, you can also distribute them vertically so the spacing is even between each. You can also distribute it horizontally. That is the fastest method. And finally, number 20, tell me what you want to do. In 2016, for all the Office apps, there's a Tell Me What You Want To Do search box, which which is very handy if you're trying to find something. So if I type in SmartArt, it gives me the choice to insert SmartArt, which is one of the selections from the menu. It also gives me help on SmartArt, and I can do a smart lookup on SmartArt, which brings up the web-based information. So this is a very handy tool to use if you're ever in need to find out information on any particular function in PowerPoint. And that concludes the top 20 PowerPoint 2016 tips and tricks. Please be sure to check out our other videos for Skype for Business, Outlook, Word, Excel, and other office applications. And thanks for watching. Hey, if you want to see more videos like this one, please subscribe. And if you've enjoyed this video, be sure to click the thumbs up and leave a comment. I really do appreciate your support.